Before we got fancy touchscreen displays, foldable phones were all the rage. And while big touchscreens are great for browsing the web and playing Goat Simulator, you really shouldn't fold them. Like, really. Now, there's the Moto Razr. It's a phone with a touchscreen that folds. This new version uses the same flexible OLED tech as the Galaxy Fold, but unlike Samsung, Moto made a phone that actually fits in your pocket. Here's the thing though, pulling it in and out of your pocket is a lot easier than pulling it apart. But that's what we're here to do, so let's get started. Some heat and an opening pick separates the back panel, allowing us to slide it down. But before it comes all the way off, we're forced to reckon with a sneakily placed fingerprint sensor cable. Hidden cables like this are frequent casualties during repair. Since the lower case of the Razr needs to slide away from the device, if you miss that sneaky cable, you're gonna have a bad day. The outer display comes off next, and it's a lot more stubborn than the lower case was. But eventually, more heat and careful prying wins the day. This little 2.7-inch OLED display comes with a minor flex cable booby trap, but we got it off intact, which is more than we could say for the outer display on the Galaxy Fold we tore down last year. Sliding the antenna assembly away from the phone, we're once again greeted with a hidden, delicate cable that needs to be disconnected before the assembly comes all the way off. Seems like booby traps are becoming a theme with this phone. We've got one of the Razr's two batteries in our sights, and after drowning it in isopropyl alcohol, we're able to pry it out of the phone. This first battery has a typical capacity of 1,245 milliamp hours. This may be a small battery, but it only represents about half of the Razr's total power reserve. There's still a second battery hidden in there somewhere. Before we get to that, we've got a motherboard to take out, and it's held in place by T3 Torx screws. In fact, all of the screws in the Razr have been T3 Torx, and we love seeing manufacturers use a single screw type in a device as it simplifies disassembly and repair. All the cables connected to the motherboard are coated in, well, goo. This goo is likely part of the Razr's splash-resistance strategy. It's probably hydrophobic, like petroleum jelly, to keep liquids away from sensitive cable connectors. This is the only water resistance measure we could identify. For $1,500, you might be getting a very cool device, but you're not getting top-of-the-line specs for your money. The Razr sports a middle-of-the-road Snapdragon 710 and 6 GB of RAM. Getting to the cameras requires removing several screws that secure a midframe and some careful board-flipping acrobatics to disconnect the second battery. This is just another example of the Razr's complexity making for awkward repairs. Finally, we remove a board that's home to both the 5-megapixel selfie cam and the 16-megapixel rear-facing camera. Several more screws in a bracket that's glued and clipped and magneted hold the Razr's folding flexi display in place. The display slides out with the secondary battery hitching a ride, and with all the difficulty in getting this sucker out, it amazes us that Motorola is offering screen replacements for only $299. That's less than an iPhone 11 Pro Max. Oh yeah, and that secondary battery, it's glued in place in a well on the underside of the display. The idea of prying a battery out against a delicate OLED display is not our idea of fun. This battery is rated at 1,265 milliamp hours, bringing the total battery capacity of the Razr to 2,510 milliamp hours, which is fairly low compared to other flagship phones. With the display out of the way, we're left with the Razr's bare frame, and we can see how the hinge works with its support plates to accomplish the folding magic. The folding act of this Razr comprises a continuous geared hinge, a cat head cam, two support plates, and a few springs. Motorola's patents illustrate the way the cam and the support plates work together to protect the fragile OLED display. They provide support and hold it taut while the phone is open, then allow for a generously loose fold, which helps to prevent a crease in the display from forming when it shuts. To Motorola's credit, all this disassembly was non-destructive, but repairing this contraption is not for the faint of heart. The Razr might be the most complicated phone we've torn down yet, and for that reason, it scores a 1 out of 10 on our repairability scale. From stubborn brackets to awkwardly layered boards, and perhaps the most intense battery replacement procedure yet, you'll have your work cut out for you. But it's cool to see what's possible, and if this design catches on, maybe Moto can work on making the next version as repairable as it is pocketable.